Yeah, welcome back to the channel. Now I have last time I was taking off the shock absorbers and spring and the whole setup on both sides on my son's 2000 model Toyota Celica 1.8 GT. So now I'm going to change everything there. On one side, on the other side I'm going to keep the spring because I was changing that short time before we get other problems. So at least I know that one is the spring is okay, so I have to save that. The other one I can just put together a completely new one. So you have to see. I have, and this shock absorber, this spring is completely new. It was changed short time ago. So I don't need to change that. This spring I have to take out and save. This one looks almost new too. So maybe it's not so old, but I have a completely new one. It's the same as this. So I just change them over. This is for the left hand. This is on the right. I know because I broke a screw here. Otherwise they are the same. Or they are not the same. These holders are not on the same side. The top screw in here is supposed to be 19. Now I had to put on clamps. Now it looks like the spring is starting to loosen a little. Just have to believe that. The top mounting plate. They think, people I talk to say that this one dry out, get rotten, and because there's a wheel bearing in here that's supposed to turn around, I put in a lot of grease here, but it was dry. Because of this one, the spring don't move as it should, and my spring was breaking because of that, they say. They did say. But it have not. There, loosen off. Need to use this one again. I think I need to use this one again. The spring and the bottom rubber. Thank you. two legs. And see, I have to put, take the other one apart too, because I need the other parts inside it. So, also see that it would be nice to put in some plastic in here so I don't ruin it from looking nice. Here it looks like it's easier to put them in like this. Locked in. Now I have to look at my cameras. And I start to put things together again. The rubber in the bottom. That one. This plate was not nice, but it's very thick. This one had to go on after the spring, of course. Spring go on here. On this side, can't see it too good on this. Move down. This side is going down, so the spring is stopping down there. Next part, of course, this guy. Going outside everything. In here, because one important thing that one of the guys who have been seeing the video was asking about, of course, I wasn't telling it, so now I put it here. When we look at the spring, the whole complete setup, when it's complete, see it directly from the side, you see that the spring is not in the center of the shock absorber. It's little over there. This mounting is on the going out to the outside. The wheel is out here, so mounting is here, and this big part is going out to the side of the car. Also, when you see on the top plate under here, this plate is also off-centered. Yeah. After I turned it around, so I have it standing out against the wheel is in out here. So you see, the plate is off center, not centered, going out, but this direction is centered. Also on the top, this direction is centered, but not this direction. So this plate is further out here. Then it's going in. The same have to be on the top plate. On the top plate, luckily, if I have been good enough to tell you guys, but on my plate it was so bad, I didn't think about it, because I was looking at the rubber muffling system. Here is going out in the top, and here you have some ears on the metal, on the rubber. Have to be on the same place. But one important and good things that's very difficult to see now, turn it around up here, it's very difficult to see on my spring. There's an arrow that's telling, this arrow should be going outside to the wheel like those here. So you should be able to think about it as a line. See if I have something here. No, I just put on something to show you. Center down here, center from the wheel, should be where the arrow is on the top plate. So it's very nice if you'll be able to find the arrow on the top. Now it lie it down. See center, the mounting here, center. You see the rubber. And mine has a line going up here. When the rubber is, for mine it's not completely perfect, yeah. On the top mount, the arrow is just a little on the side of that. I'm coming down. If you don't see the arrow, I found another way. Up here is three slices, or what do you call it? Build ups on this plate. Concave. The one in the center here is at the same place as the arrow. So if you don't see the arrow, you can use this one. And see, this is the point. Then you go down and center it. Why this is important is, of course, because when it stands on the car, the spring is a little out. I'm going a little in. It is further out here than inside, because here is the body, inner fender body of the car. Out here the car is a little bigger and I have to how the spring are reacting, not completely centered to the shock absorber. After one guy told me about that arrow, I just had to check it, because then I found out that I had put it together almost perfect, but I missed 1 centimeter on the plate here. I was a little over here. So then I just put on spring clamps, put it together again, pushed on and moved this plate over. So this arrow now is going directly to the center there. Now I'm at the arrow here. I'm at the center there. Now we jump back to the video, and this is going to be an updated version of the video. I'm closing down the first one, so you're going to see this one from now. So go on, look the rest of the video when I put it together. Next part again after this is this one. On the top of that one was a rubber thing. On top of that one was this top mount. But I'm not going to put back this one, because I can't trust this one. So I have new top mounts, new screws. So here, I'm going to complete the new one. A new screw, hopefully 19. It's big. 21. I was lucky enough to have a 21 here. 21 millimeter. Now it'd be interesting to see if I can manage to pressure this one enough down so I can start entering the bolt. There! It entered. There, the top lock is on. That spring leg is put together. There. One new leg. New top mount. New shock absorber. The spring is only a few months old since I changed it. So everything is new. The rubber thing is not new. This movement up here is very, very important. That's why I changed the top mount. There! One is finished. Now I can just go on and take the other. I have new screws for the top two. Yesterday when I was working on those shock absorber towers, my camera, first the one died, the battery, and the other one filled up the card, so I'm sorry. I didn't get to end it like I would. But I had to finish it, because I had to clean up something of my mess here. So now, you can see, you were seeing on the video that I was changing on one side. Now I'm changed both, finished. Let's see more here. New top on both, of course. New springs, one was changed before. The rubber parts are used over. This top mounting plate under this movement part. This plate is the same one, but it was rusty on the top because come up things and like there. So I had some old metal paint called Hammer It. I'm not sure if they sell it many places in the world or if it's just in Scandinavian. I'm not sure. But I put black Hammer It on the top to keep this surviving longer. I used the old rubber parts here. They are working, but they should have been new to be nicer. But they're keeping it softer. So now both the legs to the front is finished. I could have moved them straight in the car, but I have to try to find the noise, knocking noise. Someone was saying it could be the shock absorber on the right side of the car who are given after, but it's not. I tried to move it and when it was loose up and down and thing, and it's not that. The shock absorber was okay. So now I just have to try to change some more things in the front there. I have parts for more things, so I'm just going to change it. Here you see place for screwing in the brake pipe system and the sensor system. And the same on the other, but on different sides. So that's going to be nice. I'm not sure if the tough rubber thing I have on the other top mounting plate, I don't think that is going to fit here. And new screws for the top. So I'm going on new screws there. This part of the job is finished. So next now is just out in the garage and start changing other parts and start to cleaning up things and put on a rust stopper if I see something in there before I start to put together. But I have to come to back later with that. It's supposed to be warmer one day later out in the week. For a moment the temperature had dropped. We're almost 19 degrees minus Celsius now. So going out in the garage and freezing, it's no point. Just wait in, try to do some other things, try to edit this video, try to put out one other video today about when I was in the warehouse and looking at the cars there. So I have something. I have many videos lying, so I can't put out, so it's okay. So thank you. Thank you for visiting my channel. Thank you for following some of my project. I'm hoping to find a better place because, as you see in this basement, it's filled up. So I have to do something here. I was supposed to get another place, but some problems with things have to be fixed there. And they didn't have time to fix it before Christmas, so now they're stressed again, so we have to see. So please keep on following my channel. Please put a like if you like the video. Please put comments. Please go over and look over my older videos because I have more than 340 videos in the system. Many special cars, and it's coming more. So, thank you.